The boss said, Murphy, there's a phone call for you. He said, thanks, boss. Hello? Oh, Jesus. Oh, that's very sad. Thank you for letting me know. The boss said, bad news, Murphy. He said, my dad's died, sir. He said, God rest him. Now, back to work. He said, Murphy, another phone call. Oh, he said, yes, I'm busy. Oh, hello? Oh, Jesus, Mary. Thank you for letting me know. The boss said, more bad news, Murphy. He said, yes, sir. He said, that was my brother. His dad's died as well. And I'm coming back from Germany. I didn't particularly like Germany. I liked the beer. After 3 pints, you want to march into Poland. But I was very ill on the plane. And I sat next to this Irish gentleman. And I was really bad. And he was fast asleep, snoring his head off. Why do people who snore go to sleep first? And I was so ill, I got sick all over him. I thought, mother of God, he'd be bloody mad when he wakes up. So I woke him up. I said, you feeling better now, Murphy?
The fella said, what's the difference between a Rottweiler having to pee down your leg and a poodle having to pee down your leg? You let the Rottweiler finish. Hey, Pat and Mick are going down the road on Pat's motorbike. And Mick said, pull over for God's sake, Pat. I'm bloody freezing on the back of this bike. So Pat pulls over. He said to Mick, why don't you take off your jacket and turn it the wrong way round? And I'll zip it up from the back and that'll protect you from the wind. It's a great idea. So he takes off the jacket, turns it the wrong way round. Pat puts it on, zips it up. They get back on the bike. Pat's riding the bike. Mick's on the back like that. Because he can't close his arms. About a mile down the road, the bike hits a bloody big bump. And Mick goes flying off. Well, Pat doesn't notice he's missing for about 4 miles. And about 4 miles down the road, he goes to say something to Mick, and there's no sign of Mick. So he stops the bike, and he turns around, and he goes back. And there's Mick lying in the ditch. Two farmers looking at him. Pat said to the farmers, is he okay? One farmer said, well, he said... He appeared to be, he said, until he turned his head around the proper way. As an American fella, a Japanese fella, and Paddy Murphy, and they're standing at a bar having a drink, and all of a sudden a phone rings. Bring, bring. The American fella takes out a glass eye. He goes, yes, it's my goddamn cell. Sell 3 million barrels, sell now. And he puts the eye back in and he smiles. And he says, modern technology. A few minutes later, a phone rings again. Bring, bring. Japanese fella takes a little pin out of his ear. He goes, hi-ya-wa. You didn't know I could speak Japanese, did you, hey? He went, hi-ya-wa. He said, bye. Buy 3 million shares by now. And he puts the pin back in his ear and he smiles. A few minutes later, Murphy lets one go. He turned around to the American fella and the Japanese fella and he said, I think there's a fax coming through, he said. Has anyone got any paper?
Irish fella, English fella and Jew went to Rome and they had an audience with the Pope. They're there in the waiting room on a Friday afternoon. All of a sudden a cardinal comes rushing out. He says to them, listen, he says, something terrible has just happened in there. The Pope has just died. And what has happened, everyone has gone away for the weekend. There's only a few of us here. So we're going to hold the news back and we're going to say he died on Monday. Now, could we trust you three to keep that a secret? The Jewish fellow says, you can trust us. We won't say a word to anyone. Our lips are sealed. We're going back today. We won't say a word. They're on the way back in the aeroplane. The Jew turns around to the other two and he says, What odds do you think Ladbrokes would give us against the Pope dying on Monday? The English fella says, it must be 2001, maybe more. The Jew says, I'll tell you what, the three of us, we'll have a bet and we'll keep this to ourselves. We won't tell a soul, tell no one. So they get back and they meet up about a week later. And the Jew says, I cleaned up me. He says, I mortgaged the house. I got as much money on as I could. I made a fortune. The English lad says, well, I'll tell you what, he says, I'll never have to work in my life again. Oh, I made a fortune. The Irish fella said, well, I lost. The Jew says, how could you possibly lose? It was a sure thing. He says, I know. I doubled it with the Archbishop of Canterbury.